The voice from the UK, opera singer, extremely popular with everybody, Russell Watson. Just saying to my next guest, Russell Watson, his last appearance on GMA and indeed around Australia. Australians have taken him to their hearts. And there's a third album which is out now called Reprise. And this is more classical than the first couple. And it's terrific not only to have him back in Australia, but to have him on Good Morning Australia. Russell, welcome.
Thank you very much.
Now, would you like us to stand? You're worried about the creases, fine, aren't you?
Well, yeah, I was going to do the interview lying down because I don't want to crease the back of my pants. This is one of those suits.
Yeah.
As soon as you sit down in it, it sort of crumples up like
It's
that.
A great show suit, though. It looks absolutely
Thank you.
Wonderful.
Thank
sure
you.
Would like to stand? Or I mean, I'm willing to. Let's just stand up and
yeah,
see
okay,
what happens.
Yeah, sure.
So what's been happening with you since we last saw you?
Well, I've been travelling the length and the breadth of the world like this.
Yes.
So I don't crease my suit.
Yeah. Lots of work on this one.
Yeah, I mean, that album took a lot of work. I think I'd like to say the first one was the baby, the second one was the teenager, and this is the adult.
Yeah.
And I'm very pleased. I produced this one as well. The first one, I sort of had a hand in it. The second one got a bit more involved. And the third one, I decided to go all out and produce, so...
We can sit down now, by the way, and I'm going to shoot you from there up, so that'll be okay. Actually, if you want, you can take the trousers off and keep them...
Are you sure?
Yeah, sure. Okay, this is a very friendly show, you know. Russell...
Flexible should be the word, yeah.
I think the...
Oh, Christ, no, I can't do the button.
You OK? Can I help you?
Damn, I'm going to have to do the top one. It's got two buttons on it. Look, can you see?
I'll fix that for you.
Right.
Here we go. Don't worry. So how have things really been?
They've been good, Bert, yeah.
They've been great. Love your voice, love the new CD.
Thank you very much.
Yes. So does my wife. Harry. Yeah. There you go, all done. Oh. Any down the... No, everything's fine now, okay.
Oh, you bitch.
You know, the thing is, with your work, you're appealing to every demographic, which not a lot of singers do these days. I mean, the stuff that's being done for the teenagers, that seems to be one department. Stuff for the older folk up there, but you're right through it.
I like to think that people ask me what sort of fan base have we got, and I like to think that we've got a fan base that sort of goes right across the age spectrum. So from like kids to little old ladies, but predominantly I think it's sort of housewife based, the fan base.
How's America for you?
Great. First album went gold over there. And the second one's still doing well. We go back over again in another month's time to do some more re-promotion there. So we're excited about that. We've done well because there's a lot of British artists not really doing that well in the United States.
Your overnight success took 10 to 15 years in the making?
It did, yes, in the Northwest Working Men's Clubs. I think we talked about that last time, didn't we? Yeah, that was an experience, to say the least.
But probably it fits you up for what's going to happen eventually, because no audience then would phase you, I'm sure, if you can get through that sort of thing.
Once you've performed in front of five people in Wigan Road Working Men's Club, which holds about 200 people, and you can imagine five people scattered out, and really all they're interested in is talking about Coronation Street and, you know, whether the next cigarette's going to light, then, yeah. Wembley Arena is quite easy.
What is there left for you? Because you've played all the big halls. I mean, your records, as you say, go gold and platinum and the whole thing. But it just seems that you want to guide your own career. I'm sure you've got good management around you, but you know what you want to do, don't you?
Yeah, I'd like to think so. I mean, my career has taken me to places and areas that I never thought that I would end up. I mean, the performance for the Pope, the President of the United States, the Queen, things like that, I guess are things that you could only expect to happen in a lifetime, if that, you know. But the last 12 months have brought all that. And also, you know, this is a guy who's from Salford. I mean, there's no operatic tenors from Salford, for crying out loud. You know, most of them come from Italy, who left school at 16 with absolutely no qualifications. I blagged a job as an engineer. And then, hey presto, a few years later, you know, I'm one of the best-selling classical artists in the world, and there doesn't seem to be any reason for that. I mean, my mum and dad are totally non-musical. My dad's tone deaf. If he sings in the shower, forget about it. The neighbours are screaming for, you know, for miles.
They must be proud of you, though.
Yeah, they're very proud, yeah. My dad prefers it when I'm working away to when I'm at home. I've got the TVR sports car was one of the first things that I bought when I made a few quid.
Did you leave that back home, do you?
I leave it back home and my dad drives it, so he rings me up and says, are you coming back next week? Yeah.
That's lovely. What are you singing for us this morning?
Granada.
Oh, what, yes. An Australian connection there with Dorothy Dodd, who did the arrangement and part of the lyrics.
Yeah.
So that's terrific. This is the CD to look for. It's called Reprise. Anyone who hasn't heard the voice of Russell Watson, well, I'd be amazed if there is anyone, but it is just one of the magnificent voices of this new millennium. There also is the DVD, which is available too on Russell. He's about to sing for us. It's just nice to have him back, and it's terrific that he's appeared on GMA again. Thanks a lot, Russell.
Thank you, Bert.
Bless you.
Thank you.
Good luck with the button.
Thanks a lot.
Every time you button up, think of me.
Not when you unbutton, when you button.
I'll go and get my suit first now. Is that okay?
Not a worry.
Thanks.
It's just great to have him here on GMA. As I say, he'll sing for us very soon. Now on the show, here once again is Moira. As promised, here's the wonderful Russell Watson and Granada.
Granada, tierra soñada por mí, y cantar ese vuelo gitano cuando es para ti. Mi cantar es yo de fantasía, mi cantar por melancolía, que yo te veo ensangrentada al entrar despetuos, mujer que conserva el embrujo de los ojos moros, de sueño rebelde. Tengo otra cosa que darte que un ramo de rosas, de rosas de suave fragancia que llenan al mar por la Virgen Morena. Granada, tu tierra está llena de lindas mujeres.
That'll be done, Russell. Thank you. Russell Watson, this is the album to look for. It's called Reprise. It's out right now, and Russell is doing one store appearance. That's on Saturday, tomorrow, at 1 o'clock in Sydney in the Pitt Street Mall for HMV there, the HMV store in the Pitt Street Mall, tomorrow at 1 o'clock. Thanks to Russell. I've never heard the John Foreman Orchestra sound better. We couldn't put them on camera. A couple of musos are moonlighting from the ABC. But we can put Russell on again, and thank him so much for being with us. Russell Watson. Now on GMA, here's Ed.